Well, hello guys, this is Paraleo, and today we are looking at that quest. We are looking at a part of the tourist season DLC and the patch, the free patch that came along with it. But the focus of this video is not tourists, tourist DLC, but this. And I was actually trying to record this, and it was all along over here without any notification. I was waiting for it, and when in fact it was just here when I activated the DLC. Now I don't know if it's part of the tourist DLC of the free patch that comes with the DLC, but we are going to take a look at this. I highly doubt it's too long. It's not in their nature to add stuff to older DLCs. Maybe they will surprise me though. Hallowed and hallow now is the ancient glory of Taborim. Epic of Lions, look on my works, ye mighty. But I will not see its clear heart fail. It's not even voiced. Okay, the chronicles must be completed, the lost ages of Embessa restored. The temple of Elam will rise again, as will the Embessa National Museum, and your completed chronicles will be its crown jewel. I trust you will aid me in this? Of course we shall do, I'm here to serve, my lord.
I trust you will see it done.
Find the scholar on Kidusia Nitoni. Now, which one was it, man? Wahadesher. Alright, over here. Kidusia Nitoni. I have to find it. Alright. Do I have to bring a ship here? I think I have a ship.
The board is for it.
Let's get the battle cruiser. To show them we are not joking around. So I'm not gonna cover the tourists season DLC, guys. It's been covered to death. I have nothing else to add. And I will delay my town in Crown Falls until the High Life DLC appears, okay? And then I'll show you my beautiful creations. Alright, that's about it. I do have houses for 50,000 investors in Crown Falls, so the hardest part is done. What?
What a bore. We have made great progress here, but let us review what material we have before.
Oh, this is
on.
That guy I disliked. He helped us decipher that thing. The Silver Age, note to Ketema Steward. So if my voice gets broken up from time to time, it's because I'm using Nvidia broadcasts just to avoid you to suffer through my keyboard strokes and stuff like that. That thing is so good, it covers everything. One time I was recording something and a thunder just, it was a storm outside, and a thunder just made me jump out of my seat. That's how loud it was, and on the recording there was nothing. And actually was talking during the thunder, so it was so good that it actually filtered my voice from the thunder, and it didn't get on the recording. So it's a good tool. It's a good tool. That would be the only thing I don't like. Sometimes it breaks my voice. It feels like I don't like static when you talk to the radio, on a radio, you know that? Yeah. Let's focus now. Embessa's Silver Age canonically starts with the fall of King Surya and the rise of power of Rise to Power of the Seven. I don't remember too much, but I remember I liked the Embessa storyline. I would have loved it to be even more developed, but it was what it was. It is usually seen to end with the Sundering of the Seven. Questions that need answering. Which island was never governed by one of the Seven? One of the islands at the time was described as leaderless. The remains of the Seven's houses can be found on the islands near Taborim, where they ruled.
An attack.
If you can find, I should.
A competitor's island withstood an attack.
We might not hear the Emperor if he talks to us, if I reduce the NPC's voices to zero.
The assignments due soon.
Oh, I wanted to read some more. Oh, we got it. We got it. Okay. How large was Taborim? By all accounts, the city flourished under the Seven's rule. Finding the ancient city walls could help estimate the limits of the city at the time. It can't have been much greater than the city today, so perhaps look near the city's current borders. Note, please report back as soon as possible. Okay, sir, I'm here to serve. Yeah. I looked at it. Prince's palace is off the ruins.
Ceasefire has ended.
We are at Kidusi. So let's take a look around. This is the library. This shouldn't really. Ogdoad. Find the Og, the holy Ogdoad. Alright. So if there are no palaces. Oh. I wonder, do I have to have a ship next to the islands? Maybe we should send some ships close by, so let's prepare a bit.
This. Duty.
Why are you here? What was I planning? Oh, let's send you close to Angereb, but not too close.
On course.
All right, we need one ship. No, we are using this one for the other island. Okay, let's see. One was not governed. I feel like this wasn't governed. This was supposed to be a history, a library.
A competitor's island is under siege.
Yeah, I don't think over here we'll find any palaces. Yeah, this was a place of culture.
Ready for action.
Yeah, let's go to Kidusi in case we have something to loot. Wahadesher Island. Man, I'm bad with names in general. After I passed 30, I started that. It was a new trait that I won.
Engines underway.
By leveling up to 30 years old. Not remembering names for long. Of course, I remember the names of friends and families, but other than that, if I don't talk to somebody too much, I will forget their name. All right.
The people celebrate your leadership.
Yeah, but we explored this island. This was the passage to the stone, right? Yeah, we remember what this is about. So I will add this episode.
Oh, a renowned person.
I will add this episode to the Embassa playthrough. I will be editing it. Old man's house. I don't remember all the details. Oh, so it's only in one of them. Then it should be on Angareb, right? House is found, 0 out of 2. So there are 2. Prominent house. Ancient family house. Possibly the only house to survive the unification. Of course it disappears very fast. Alright. So, possibly a house who survived the wars. That's all I got until it disappeared.
Battle deck to attention.
You are luckier than me. You can pause the video and look it up. Now, I will assume the other one is on Angareb. Because it makes sense, right? It's a city-state, it's a fortification state, I don't know how to say it. Okay, this hideous house. See? Yeah, we found them. So house 2 and house 1 is this one. I saw people are using my playthrough to find stuff, so that's why I recapped. Let's look at
the borders for us.
Find traces of Taborim Silver Age fortification. Let's look it up. Silver Age fortifications. They should be on this mountain path, right? I don't see any connection with the lower fields. I see something over here, no? Like a path that's blocked by the farm right now. The animals still move weird. Oh my god. Really, with so much. Let's not get into that. Yeah, I'm brutally honest.
A competitor's island.
It's not a good trait in this day and age. To be like that, to look over here also. Don't remember if this was here. Yeah, see. Okay. And what's over here? And we should. Now we know what we are looking. Let's not get sidetracked. We found a wall. Where could the other ancient wall be? So this was one of it. And this is, yeah. So it doesn't disappear as long as you keep the mouse on, I don't know. Sure, let's report to the scholar because he's our boss.
Battle deck to attention.
A competitor's island is under siege.
I am a bit ticked off, but yeah. But nothing too bad. It's related to other stuff.
Pumping smoke, Admiral!
But what Why am I making so much cash, guys? I don't know. Look at 500,000 royal taxes. Whoa. Queen is greedy as hell. I'm playing Biomutant after this, so that's why I don't cover the tourists, but you have seen it. The drops on Twitch and stuff like that, and all the sparkling conversation over there, I guess, you know, seen enough.
Let me see. Quite passable. Carry on. I've gathered some more information for you in a note.
Oh, thank you, sir. Thank you. The Bronze Age.
People celebrate your leadership.
Notes to Ketema Stewart. Scholars attest that Embezzah's Bronze Age began with the unification of the land under the rule of Yet Barok, heir of Selamawi, after the fall of the Seven, and ended when Lebne's grandson was murdered in anger barely a century ago. Despite this recent history, sorry about that, some questions remain unanswered. The roster of works built by Yet Barok is incomplete. He is known for his many defensive installations against the Sands Kingdom in Angareb, Taborima, and Kidusi, as well as the Tsar walls on Wahadesher. Investigate each of these and report to me. Where is the fable hidden access button? Didn't we use that? And to the temple on Kidusi Anitoni. Yet Barok was known for building secret passages in his strongholds. I remember that thing. I didn't use the temple access. I went through the mountains, right? For fear of successful invasions. While the passage on Angareb and the mountain pass on Wahadesher are known, the passage below the temple of on Kidusi remains hidden. Perhaps you could find it. Please report back as soon as possible, of course. Sir.
If you could oblige.
Yes, sir. Wasn't it this one? You entered over here. And they forgot they were using this in the other quests. So you were entering this place and you were getting out. Let me remember, over here, basically. Yeah, so we found it. We're so good, so good. Yeah, but I remember I sent a spy to use the mountain path because I thought this was more deserted, and the dumbass fell off at some point, if I remember correctly, and he got injured, right? The well-trained spy. All right, now, what else do we need to find? Let's look on Angareb first. So defensive installations. We are looking for defensive installations. What could be considered as a defensive installation? The towers. Yeah, I didn't like that this wasn't rebuilt. Alright, now let's see. You can see we have a tower missing over here. I don't know, no, we're not missing any towers, maybe over here, no, I don't know what to say. Let's go back on Taborim. Man, hai. Okay.
We're in the presence of a virtuoso.
Yeah, sure, Bruno is always welcome. Defensive installation. Walls of the palace court. Yeah. Okay. So let's recover. Let's recap. So first, you have to find two houses. Right.
A competitor's
one is
island
this
is
one.
Under siege.
Yeah. And one is this one. Okay, then you have to find remains from the Bronze Age. All right, one is this. One is this, and one is this, the walls at the palace. I was expecting something on the outskirts, that's why I was looking. Defensive installations. This is part of the palace, but okay. Hidden pathway. Find a hidden path through the mountains of... This was in the other... My god, guys. I think this is supposed to be played after.
You've done.
I don't know when it's supposed to be played.
Use it constructively.
Let's find a hidden path.
Money is dirty but necessary.
Think we have to. Yeah, I have to find the other. The exit in order to complete this. Where was it? Over here. Let's see if this is it.
The report is detailed, of course.
As always.
We're nearing the end of our trials. One chapter remains. That of your own tribulations in Invisa.
Okay. So this part was weird a bit.
At last, our magnum opus is complete. I have had several copies made. Masterful craftsmanship, if I do say so myself.
Yeah, I think it wasn't
there
meant
it is.
To be.
A final, exhaustive, comprehensive copy of the Chronicles of the Land of Lions. Shall
yes.
We?
So this bit wasn't supposed to be played now. It was supposed to be played when we were working on Kitusi. But, yeah, sure. Let's take a look.
These chronicles herald a new golden age. The Age of Lions. The triumph of Mbesa. And we, the architects of its splendor.
Alright. Thank you.
Light blazes the soul of Mbesa.
Alright. Oh. Right, now we have the chronicles, actual chronicles, not just an icon. Long before Mbesa existed, its people lived in the blessed realm of Silamidos, where God had laid his head to rest after creation, only guarded by her son Elam the Young, which held the broken covenant. Oh my god, oh my god. Let's read it all. Skip ahead if you are bored. Chapter 1. Let's not read it. Let's not read it. Oh my god. Oh my god, I can't read everything. Oh my god, no. 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 Let's read our accomplishment. Let's read our accomplishments. Ooh. Alright. Alright. It's interesting. It's interesting. Alright, I'm to be continued. Yeah, let's read the last one. The advent of Ketema. Amid the chaos, one man rose to power. Ketema, no longer a young, inexperienced man, raised a large, well-trained army and took province after province under his authority, raining wrath, fire, and blood upon those who betrayed his family to King Wag's ambitions. Although victorious, this whirlwind of violence left many of the conquered population ill-disposed toward their new sovereign, resenting him for his relentless execution of even the mildest dissenters. Building a new embassy, wise to the dangers of a restless population, the newly crowned King Ketema expended considerable efforts into a grand and ambitious project for his new realm, sparing no efforts to rebuild the historical capital of Taborim around the newly raised palace of splendid proportions. Claiming the title of Emperor of all Embessa, Ketema sent envoys to all the places, the last isles of independence in the realm, to negotiate terms for reconciliation and peaceful integration into the empire. But the shadows of history and the threat of the old world are never truly quelled, and there are those among the wise who fear that with the recent opening of the Grand Canal, the eyes of the allies and foes of old may turn to Embessa, and its shores may be trod by foreign feet once more. To be continued. This was it, guys. Yeah. You have no quests. Yeah. I guess this was the first part was supposed to be played while you were doing the Kidusi quest line, because it was just too much around that. And the second part, this book, you are, in fact, I think we received one copy, right? We received one copy. How much is it worth? Okay, so it seems this was it. I was expecting I wasn't expecting something too long, but not really that short though. Okay, so this was the new quest they added along the tourist DLC to Embessa storyline. Seems to be optional, and I don't know if something else appears. I will add it to the Embessa playthrough. Alright guys, this was it. Bye bye.